presentation, there's a technical failure. Anyway, I thought of to have the topic here like sustainability in teaching, research and practice. I'm sorry about what has happened with the change in the computer. So when we were talking about this sustainability, it is very important that sustainability have to be included in every aspect of our teaching, research and practices. As you know that we have been talking in many ways about what is going on our environment. It was at the beginning more nature, but day by day it becoming the, this is what the past, and this was, we had a more nature. Before now what has happened, it more in built environment. I'm not going to into the more into the detail of, because from yesterday to today, everybody is talking about this situation. So this is what going on. This is where we were. Now day by day, we are going toward the direction. Then here in the morning, rather than going much into the detail, as an civil engineer, I thought of come to the special topic where, rather than talking about the more on general, as a civil engineer, how I promote sustainability. So that the, I'll start with this one because I got the project. So I changed the project to a greener project. So start from here because I skipped the mostly what I have been wanted to talk in at the beginning. So I was given a project as a civil engineer. I changed it to the greener project. I'll briefly explain it. I'm not even go much into detail about the sustainable engineering. Basically, we have to take care of the resources for the future generation. This is the problem. So about 2 years before, in Puttalam, you see the one end, you get the limestone, the other end is a factory. This is about 43 kilometers. So I was got a telephone call, and they just want to see, they have got the 5 bridges in between these 42 kilometers. They had a whole engine, it's about 80 ton. They're going to import, I mean, they have already placed the order and the engine is coming to Sri Lanka, it is like 100 ton. So they're worried about the 5 bridges on this line. They just asked me to whether can you come and check whether these bridges are capable of carrying the additional load. Basically, it's like this. There's 5 bridges, so they just wanted to see whether these 5 bridges are capable of carrying this load. What I basically did was I did assessment of these bridges. I'm not going into the detail about the methodology of assessment. Basically, it comprises of the condition survey and material testing and load testing. It's like this is a condition survey because each and every member of the bridge will be inspect for their condition. And the material testing is the, we take sample and do the testing in the laboratory. These are the, some photographs of the tensile testing and the fatigue, then the material composition. Then we do the load testing and see whether, actually right now, today we are doing one bridge in close to the Nawala. I inspect the site in the morning. Students are doing the, that bridge testing even today morning. They will finish within today. So then the, these are the data we will get. So this is interesting for you. This is what was my conclusion. I said the first bridge was very good condition. The second one is a very poor condition. When you even look at the bridge, you might see that the condition is not that good. The third one is a good, okay, and good. That means that basically my recommendation, you do something for the second bridge as soon as possible. So this is the bridge that was subject to a 1970s cyclone and washed off. And they have kept in the temporary location, assuming that the later they can replace with either new bridge or the after repairing. But that has not been done. So that is why you can see the condition of the bridge. So this is the bridge that I was talking to replace. So this is the discussion with the management. So management wanted to go for the new bridge. I was proposing a repair, basically we said the retrofitting. But I had to withdraw the idea because they are very keen on going for the new bridge. So I designed the new bridge. But at the end of the design, I presented my case. So there was several points that I presented. One was cost factor. I said that if you go for the new bridge, that cost nearly 70 million. But if you go for the retrofitting, I can guarantee the bridge, it costs like the 76 plus. As usual, money works. So what happened is that they accept the idea of the retrofitting or the repair, but they withdraw the idea of the new bridge. So then concept of the reduction of the cement, water, electricity, and so forth. We reuse the bridge itself, and then we recycle. We ask them to rethink about their decision. So this is where the POR work very well. Mainly target is the reuse of the material. Then there was one question. The bridge is not in the line, so they wanted to know how I am going to take it to the original location. So when I simply say that, they say, no, we want to see how we are going to do it. So I came up with the animation where I jack up the bridge, as you see here. Then I inserted the rail. Then in the meantime, I say that I can bridge my piers. Then later I can bring back to the position where I wanted. So they were convinced and they are happy. So we started the retrofitting work, sandblasting and replacing the member that has been subject to the heavy fatigue load and so forth, corroded members. And this is some photographs of the retrofitting works. You can see some part has been removed. Now this is what we have to do. Now foundation work has started. Now foundation is coming up slowly. Last concrete in like, so that now bridge is ready to move to the new location or the original location. Right? Rail line both sides is straightened. Now this is the last train on Friday evening. So we have been given the 2 days. Within the 2 days, we will have to make sure that bridge will be in the new location. So we have to bring to them. So now as the animation, we are jacking up the bridge. Bridge is coming up. So as in the animation, we have put the rail girders and apply some grease in order to bring the bridge back to the original location. We use the very primitive technique. We use the support at the boat side and then use the chain block. Because we are working in the jungle, we don't want to give the heavy movement to the bridge that might very damaging. It might go into the river. I mean, we cannot take the train or anything to pull it back. So we use the very primitive technique, just using the labor and pulling the bridge to the original location. Now bridge has come to the original location, still on the rail line, so we have to jack and de-deck. So it is just the animation, the photographs of the before and now. So now it has come to the, this is the first train after 2 days, moving on the bridge itself. Now it come to the opening. Many engineers and architects are complaining that we do design, we do a lot of work, but we are not recognized. But in this case, you might see that they have recognized me. I have been invited to the opening of the bridge. So the opening ceremony is happening. Now bridge is at this stage now. We have practiced the most of the sustainable things, like the taking care of the safety, waste, and many, many things. At the end of the day, we planted more trees than we have to remove during the construction. Not only that, as like the building tuning, we tune the structure, We did it, for example, we are doing the reassessment of the bridge of the construction, just for the one idea. We have the data when the train engine stop on the bridge. At that time, we had one parameter like displacement. It is 19 millimeters, but after the doing the retrofitting, we found that that is 6 millimeter. This is only the one direction. Other direction, displacement and acceleration and the strain and various other things were measured, and we found that everything is better than before. It's like in the building tuning, we have to tune the structure. Our recommendation is every year, like, we have to do the testing and see the performance. If the performance is getting out of the shapes, we have to go for the maintenance. Therefore, not only building and bridges, every structure that we are made building, you should go for the tuning. So likewise, we proved that the tuning has been done. This is a sustainable solution. I have recently traveled to the Jaffna. I found that there are so many similar bridges has been taken away and imported new bridge. This is where we call sustainability, in the political sustainability, because at that point they are thinking about the commission, not about the replacement. Because if you go for the retrofitting, they don't get any commission, but if you go the replacement, they get the commission. That's not, because in order to achieve the total sustainability, we have to not only engineering sustainability, architect sustainability, we have to social sustainability, economic sustainability, every angle we should have sustainability. That's what my the topic of my presentation was, the promotion of sustainability, teaching, research and practice. So that every angle, we are not talking about the engineering, we are not talking about the architectural aspects. Every angle we have to target a sustainability in order to achieve the total sustainability. So again, I thought I have some few more slides, but even right now, you can see that there is a transformation going on in Colombo. So without political backing, we cannot come up there. Even the Green Building Council, we always believe that in order to achieve the total sustainability, that what we believe, we really need to go for the political backing. Sometimes we professionals don't like to go behind the politician. But if you want to really achieve the total sustainability, we need the backing of the political sustainability. So with that, I will conclude my presentation. Thank you so much.